Madden Football is the home of the Super Bowl, and this historic matchup is brought to you by EA Sports. It's the Niners and the Chiefs, and it's coming up next.
It's the National Football League, presented by EA Sports. Tonight, it is all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy, as it'll be the AFC champion Kansas City Chiefs taking on the NFC champions, the San Francisco 49ers. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Charles, we don't like to throw around the word dynasty loosely, but for the Chiefs, it applies. I mean, they're looking for their third title now in 5 years.
And with the way this league is configured now, it absolutely applies. I think you're totally on target. Remember, they lost a Super Bowl in there too. So to be back for the fourth time in 5 years, in today's NFL, that's pretty incredible.
Meanwhile, for the 49ers, they were one of the heavy favorites to win the NFC, and they were able to get it done, and now they look for that elusive sixth Super Bowl title.
Remember, after going 5-0 in their first five appearances here, they've lost two straight, Super Bowl 47 to the Ravens in New Orleans and Super Bowl 54 to Kansas City in Miami. They'd love to start another streak like they had in the 80s when they won four Super Bowl titles.
The 2023 season has one game left. Here we go. Super Bowl 58 underway from Vegas. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21. So here's the first drive now for the 49ers. And they will be led out by their signal caller in his second year of the NFL now.
And there's a word that constantly gets thrown around with this guy when you talk to anyone in the building. Potential. They are sky high on what they believe he can grow into in the role of a starting quarterback. In addition, there are plenty around the league who think that as well. And years from now, he can still be leading this offense out.
The drive begins with a run by McCaffrey. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and six.
Nice chunk of yards on first down. It really opens up your options for what you want to do on second. You go right back to him and hope he explodes, or sucker the defense in before throwing over the top.
From the 25, here's second and six. Connects with Kittle underneath. Get this one across the 35. 13 yards there and a Niner first. That's probably as simple of a throw as he'll have all game.
And good for everyone. Good for his completion percentage. Good for the receptions for the receivers. But you know how they work on that. They have footballs with no laces. So that as soon as you get the snap, you're just throwing the football. All right? You're not trying to find the laces and grip it a certain way. That takes time. Just get the ball and throw it. So that's how they practice it all the time now, too.
Yeah, he will go out. 35-yard line. That one 28 yards on the ground. So back-to-back big runs picking apart this defense on the opening drive.
I thought this was a passing league. I thought this was the era we were in where the ball was always in the air, right?
They didn't get the memo.
They didn't get the memo, and I know this to be true. Offensive linemen still, to this day, they want to run the football. They want to fire out and hit people across the line of scrimmage, and they're clearing space.
On first down, this is McCaffrey, and he'll be taken down at the 34. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
A gain of two there on the heels of a one-yard pickup on first. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
The 25-yard line is what they need here. This is third down. Purdy looking to throw. Look in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he is going to have a 49ers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Solid opening drive so far, Charles. They've moved this football into field goal range, but you know that they want to cap this off with six and not three.
Absolutely. As one of the better coaches in the league always tells me, on offense, I want their body blows all game long and finish it with uppercuts. Well, here are the body blows right now. He's hoping in one uppercut will take care of the end of this drive.
And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. 50 yards rushing for him now on their opening drive in the Super Bowl. They've taken this opening kickoff and marched it right down the field defensively. Not much resistance.
And that's the point, because my admiration is for the guys moving the ball right now. They know what they're doing. Their plan is working. But I flip it over and watch and say, okay, what are you going to do to change things up? Because if you don't...
And he holds it in the end zone. Touchdown, San Francisco. Juwan Jennings from 8 yards out, and the 49ers are on the board first here in this Super Bowl.
Brandon, this is the Super Bowl. A touchdown scored in any game is big. In this one, it's massive.
Jake Moody now for the point after. And the 49ers grab a 7-0 lead. So an 8-play drive covering 80 yards. And it's polished off by a touchdown for San Francisco. So following the touchdown, here's Moody back out to send it away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. Here's the Chiefs offense for their first possession, and it's Patrick Mahomes at quarterback.
And simply put, for many, he's the gold standard for quarterbacks in today's NFL because of his ability to create, find the open man, use all the different arm angles that he has. He's a complete package, and boy, his team loves to play around him.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air. That's complete. It's Travis Kelce. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 16 yards right off the bat with a first down.
Good job there to locate his tight end, Charles, in the middle of the field.
Yeah, he has good pass-catching abilities, and if they're able to continue to find him here in the early going, I think it'll help out his teammates out on the perimeter. You can take the big shots later if he occupies their attention.
And the Niners get there and bring him down.
No surprise there. Chase Young wrecks that play with a sack.
And we all know how talented this guy is who's calling the signals for him. But even the best in the game, they can struggle against a good cohesive zone coverage. Can't find a gap in the secondary quick enough, and he ends up taking a sack.
Now Mahomes throwing on second down. Man open, that's Marquez Valdes-Scantling. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. The Chiefs have got the passing game rolling a bit, and another first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Throwing on first down is Mahomes.
On the throw, led him too much that time. It's incomplete.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game that has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still two more downs to connect and try and pick up another first down.
Here's second and 10. Here's Mahomes to throw. Open man, it's the tight end, Kelce. And this will move the chains again as the tackle is going to be made at the 49ers' 34-yard line. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
And that was good protection there. No, that was great protection there because it allowed him to lock in on his receiver, although I think he was looking for his tight end on the corner route all the way. Nice connection there for a really nice gain.
They'll swing this out to Tony.
This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two. Zero hesitation that time. That was get ball, throw ball.
Yeah, turn into a smoke route. If you see the coverage off the receiver, doesn't matter whether you call it a run or not. Just take the ball, get it out to him.
Now a second and two. Mahomes now to throw. And his throw is incomplete.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move them all over the place to try and find good matchups. And they had one, they were just unable to complete the pass.
They're trying to keep the drive going. This will be play number eight. It's third and two. They'll run out of the gun with Pacheco. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. An 11-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Chiefs first down. Quite the opening drive march they're on right now.
It looks a lot like what we saw in practice prior to the game, doesn't it? You know, because on that last big practice beforehand, you go through your offensive script. You go through your play calling. You go through all the stuff and establish things, and it looks like it's going like clockwork right now for them.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
They're bringing a lot of pressure here already in the first quarter. Already sacked him once. Now they get in there and knock another one away. You think maybe that Tucker rule being gone makes defenses a lot bolder?
Yes, indeed. That time, lucky that the arm was going forward. Incomplete pass. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Looking to throw is Mahomes. And this one is going to be off the mark, too far out in front.
Man coverage is certainly a staple of their defense, and it's built for plays like that, forcing that incompletion.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Now Mahomes. And he's caught, and in for the Chiefs touchdown. Mahomes hitting his favorite target, Travis Kelce, on the touchdown pass. And the Chiefs are an extra point away from tying this Super Bowl at 7.
We're still in the first quarter, but it's apparent they're going to have to come up with a different defensive game plan for him, because right now he's kind of having his way against that defense and has added a touchdown to the list. How do you slow him down? They're going to have to mix up some coverages, maybe change who's guarding him.
Harrison Butker is on for the extra point. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. And the 49ers getting set to trot out there.
So both of these teams, Charles, coming off touchdowns now, but this offense, they just had to stand on the sideline, watch their opponent author a really impressive drive to reach the end zone.
Yeah, and I think you're not telling yourself the truth if you don't think there's some one-upsmanship going on right now, because they just had their touchdown answered by a drive of double-digit plays that also found the end zone. Now they want to do something even more impressive to answer that one.
The tight end Kittle has it on the left side. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
He had the touchdown earlier. This one's going to get him a first down.
I know this may be jumping the gun a little bit, but 7-7, they're flinging it around like crazy. Look at the drive that's going on here. Partner, we may have to start thinking about one of these defenses just holding someone to a field goal and maybe trying to get an advantage that way.
This is McCaffrey.
And he fights forward for a modest 2-yard gain, second down.
Well, sometimes as a running back, you've got to be able to improvise when the hole's not where you expect it to be. But in this case, there wasn't any improvisation that he could do that was going to work. Kind of like if you're trying to be a comedian on open mic night at the Improv and you run into a tough crowd.
Second down and right back to McCaffrey.
And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30.
72 yards rushing for him now as he has gotten the night off to a hot start.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
So now first and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 32-yard line. They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again.
Taken down at the 30.
A big part of a middle linebacker's job is being able to take on blocks and then go make plays. But the best ones, they have those big guys in front of them playing defensive line to hold blockers off of them and allow them to flow sideline to sideline and make the big hits.
A second and 7 with our score tied at 7, but they're planning to change that soon. Only question, will they get 3 or 6 out of it?
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
Purdy with it on third and long.
And this is going to be incomplete. The Kansas City defense tough to throw on there, and now it's fourth down.
Smart move to throw that one away. You're in field goal range, so you definitely don't want to be loose with the ball. And that's great work by this defense to force a fourth down.
So Purdy off and Moody on for the 49er field goal.
From the right hash, it's a 46-yard attempt. And this one is right down the middle. And they take the lead here now at 10-7.
Well, in a close game like this, obviously you want the touchdown, but certainly they will take the 3.
And they'll be okay with that, but let's throw a little credit to the defense as well. And I'm just glad this doesn't come down to a debate, right? Which side won, partner? Because the defense, hey, we didn't give up a touchdown. The offense, hey, we put 3 on the board. Either way you look at it, I think both sides gained something out of that drive.
So here's Moody back out there now to send this one away. And he won't quite make it to the 25.
Kansas City taking the field for their second drive. They trail early on in this Super Bowl as they come up first and 10.
They'll start the drive here with Pacheco.
And he'll take it forward for about 5 up to the 28-yard line.
Oh, that was a thing of beauty right there. Look at how quick those blockers fired off the line once the ball was snapped. That was an O-line on a mission, all in sync. And the defense is lucky that play only picked up 5 yards.
From the 28, it's 2nd and 5. Again, it's Pacheco.
And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. That one good for 12 yards into Kansas City first.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. And he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
Mahomes firing complete, and he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. 11 more on that one, and another first down.
Nice little nifty play for him there. Yeah, that's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backside of the backfield, because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got everybody oh, he just snuck out there, and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. Maybe just a lack of concentration there as he couldn't haul it in.
And when you're going across the middle like that, you know, he's running that drag route, you are conscious of all the bodies and the traffic in there. But let's face it, if you're going there, you might as well come down with the football and absorb whatever else happens after that.
And down he goes. The 49ers get there.
The pressure from multiple guys there as they bury him for a big 9-yard loss.
I thought there at the end he may have had a chance to release that, but that pocket closed a little too quickly and down he went.
Yeah, he was certainly trying to do everything he could to extend the life of the play, probably counting in his head, 1, 2, and then he ran out of time.
After the sack, things get a little tougher here. Third and long for Mahomes and the Chiefs. He'll drop to throw. They'll set up the screen to Edwards-Helaire. And they'll bring him down right at midfield, and he is well short of the first down. That'll bring up fourth down. They wind up getting 8 yards, but they needed more than that.
I wonder what was going through his mind when he got the play call. He just got sacked on the previous play. He knows they're coming after him again. A little bit of guts to stand in there, take the hit, and successfully complete the screen pass. Really well done.
No returning this one. It sails out of bounds, and they'll spot it right at the 20. Out on the field now, here come the 49ers. And they split the uprights last time for 3. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it, touchdowns.
He'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
Partner, one thing I was lousy at growing up, track and field, I could never anticipate the start before a race, but how about that backer? He figured it out, jumped the count, and turned it into a really nice play for his defense.
He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of 2.
Watching that play unfold and watching him complete it brought back memories of doing all those pursuit drills to make sure you don't over-pursue and let a guy get a cutback lane on you. He did that very well.
You praised him on tape yesterday for the angles that he takes to the ball. Took a great angle right there.
That brings us to the end of one in Super Bowl 58. Much more to come from Las Vegas after this.
10-7 our score. We'll return after this message. You're watching the NFL, and it's right here on EA Sports.
And we are back. Biggest game of the year, the Super Bowl, and both teams ready for the start of the second quarter. He's got his target. That's complete.
And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. A gain of 22.
And time to give some credit to the big fellas, the offensive line here, because you've got to have good protection on crossing routes because you've got to give your receiver time to work all the way across the field. That time, be able to scan the field, spot his receiver moving left to right, and make a good, accurate throw. Thank you, guys.
On first down, it's Purdy. And this one nearly picked off. Kind of surprising to see a defender of his caliber let it get away, but get away it does, and it's 2nd down.
Those are the ones you dream of as defenders. I think if he gets eyes on the ball a little bit earlier, he might come away with it. Instead, it's going to wind up as just an incomplete pass.
Here's Purdy.
Well, that'll be incomplete. Well, he took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a 3rd down.
It's always tough trying to keep your guy upright when he's trying to throw the football. When you're dealing with those big, bad guys on the defensive front, it's even tougher. And this time, those guys on the opposite side won the battle, getting to the quarterback and knocking him into an incompletion.
Here's Purdy now on 3rd and goal. Yeah, to the right sideline, and it falls incomplete.
Well, they came up with points in their first 2 possessions, but it looks like they'll come up empty here on their 3rd drive. The defense finally starting to get locked into them a little bit. Might have to go a little bit deeper into their playbook on their next possession.
On 4th down, the Niners trot out Mitch Wishnowski to punt the football. Waiting on it will be Richie James. Fair catch called for right around the 11-yard line. A 41-yard punt there with no return. And the Chiefs are going to take over with a long field ahead and a first and 10. Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 11. They'll start this drive out on the ground. And he'll take this one only up to about his 13-yard line.
Tackle made by Chase Young.
Well, partner, I don't think it's any secret that any running back wants to be able to see a hole open so that he can gallop through it. But in this case, he had to slow down. There was really no hole there. And he took a big hit in order to get that 1 yard.
Mahomes going to throw.
And that'll be caught by Tony.
And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped.
But following the play now, they're going to stop the clock here as a man is shaken up.
We'll take a break and get a report from Vegas after this. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Throwing now is Mahomes. Complete, the tight end Kelsey. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about, and you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent, and that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
And again, it's Mahomes. Got an open man, it's Valdez Scantling. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
Timing is so important on a route like this because he's going to line up out right and then cut straight across the field. I think the ball might have come out a count or two too late because by the time he was able to secure it, not much of a chance to turn it upfield.
This offense on third down today, they've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and four. And the Niners get there and bring him down. Nick Bosa drops him for a loss of 10, and it's going to be fourth and long.
These sacks now, they're starting to pile up, Charles, and that front seven defensively, they've had their way with this offensive line.
And I think at this stage, we have to start thinking about different play calls. We've got to start helping this quarterback out because the entire game, he's been under siege. I don't care what the down and distance, they've got to get the ball out of his hands a lot quicker.
On fourth down, Tommy Townsend to punt for Kansas City. This is taken at about the 14. They'll net only 35 here following a 43-yard boot, 8-yard return. And out will come the offense as they take over. Out comes Christian McCaffrey with the rest of the offense. And it may just be the second quarter, but he's in his zone well on his way to eclipsing that 100-yard mark.
And when a back has a game, as we're witnessing right now, his name's going to be in the books. But it's really a collective deal, isn't it? Because that means he's getting plenty of blocking, a lot of help from his teammates, but he's making the most of it.
Yeah, he's made the most of it to this point.
Purdy going to lead the 49ers to the line, first and 10 at their own 23. And he'll start by handing this off to McCaffrey.
Takes this up just short of the 30, but he was able to avoid that earlier tackle. Nice move.
83 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here in this first half.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball, but when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
Another run with McCaffrey on second down.
And McCaffrey going to pick up a Niners first down as he'll get this up past the 35-yard line.
That's a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Back to throw, Purdy. He'll get this into the hands of Ayuk. And down he goes at the 45 after a pickup of 9.
Simple drag route here, lined up out left and tried to work his way back across the field. You probably saw me twitch there, partner, because I think he wanted the ball a little bit sooner. By the time he looked it in, defender was right on him.
On second down, McCaffrey. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and now they're faced with a 3rd and 1.
CD, put on your OC cap here. What do you do? 2nd and 1, you get stuffed. Now 3rd and 1.
You know, in the old days, I would have said we're going to line up and we're going to run the same darn play and we're going to get it right. But nowadays, as tough as defenses are, I want some mobility. I want some movement, putting the ball in the hands of my quarterback and giving him a run-pass option.
First down, San Francisco, to pick up 14 yards.
This guy's well on his way now to a big game on the ground. It's another good run there. Puts him over the century mark in yardage, and we're still in the second quarter.
So now 1st and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 41. Purdy from the gun. Samuel bringing in the slant. So the completion good for just 3. And it'll be 2nd down.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game, because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
From the shotgun to McCaffrey. And he'll be taken down at the 33, a pickup of about 4.
Well, partner, they've been running it well the entire game, and the big guys up front, they're a huge reason why. And now they're reaping the benefits as they continue to open up big holes and gain nice yardage.
They're trying to keep the drive going. This will be play number 8. It's 3rd and 2. A handoff, McCaffrey running right. And he's going to get to the 31, enough for the first down.
Well, someone's been having a good game so far, and you know something? A lot of it's been power running. They decided to turn him loose again on 3rd down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards. They go play action here, Purdy. And that one into the hands of Ayuk downfield. Touchdown, 49ers! Brandon Ayuk. 31 yards, and the 49ers are able to widen their advantage.
All the receivers in the league are plenty good enough, otherwise they wouldn't make it in the NFL. But the ones that go to the Pro Bowl, they have refined route running ability.
Now Moody for the PAT. It's good to make it 17-7. That time, a 9-play drive.
And it was Brandon Ayuk capping it off with a touchdown reception.
So after the made field goal by Moody, he's back out to kick this one away. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. And out come the Chiefs now. They find themselves down 17-7 as they start this drive 1st and 10.
Thank you.
Now here's Mahomes. And he's got his big wide receiver complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive, first down.
Well, this is where reading defenses and practice time comes into play. You've got to know what you're running versus zone versus man and how to run the proper route. And they just executed that one pretty well.
They go play action. Now Mahomes. Caught. Kelsey, left side. And they will only muster a yard here to the 38.
I know the halftime's approaching, but I don't think he's going to want to take a break. That's his fifth catch.
Yeah, they've really been targeting the tight end.
38-yard line, second and nine.
To throw, it's Mahomes. Side here, and it's complete. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers 45-yard line. Catch number four for him on the afternoon, and it'll give him a first down.
Well, this hasn't really been a first half to remember on either side of the ball, but I think this kind of makes this an important drive. You'd love to get this back to a one-score game if you can, and that's good work there to get some yardage here and pick up the first down.
On play action, it's Mahomes. The throw out wide going to be incomplete.
Offense was moving it a little bit, had them back on their heels, but they earned a brief pause by forcing the incompletion. That gives them a quick chance to regroup and try and mount a stand before they're backed up even further.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Looking to throw is Mahomes. And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's third down.
This is part of why this guy's got multiple MVPs on the mantle. We're used to seeing him make the impossible throws, but here Mahomes knows he's got nothing, so he wisely just gets rid of it.
The Chiefs on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is third and 10. They go play fake. Mahomes steps away to his left. A nice job there on the escape and scramble. A first down, a 16-yard gain.
Well, here's your first example of how this guy can beat you in more ways than one, because they took away his arm, but he was more than happy to dissect them with his legs for that first down pickup.
On first and 10, here's Mahomes. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
He didn't just deny a big throw there. He broke that one up in the red zone. An excellent play, one that may help save points on the board when this drive is over.
Here's second and 10 now from the 29. They fake the give. Now Mahomes. Short throw hauled in by Kelsey. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers 16. They call his number again. It's his sixth catch and a first down.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against him a few minutes ago, because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there. And they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10.
Operating from the red zone now, Mahomes. It's Kelsey on the ground. And he is out of bounds, getting it down to the 10. So the completion good for 6 yards, and it's second down. He's been a busy man here in this one, and they're showing off some nice footwork to stay in bounds.
And with those types of catches and the volume that we've seen in this game, wouldn't you keep him busy as well?
I would.
Of course, you got to keep throwing it to him. He keeps making plays.
Second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete. That is the first time that they've targeted him that he has not come down with a catch.
He's caught everything that's been thrown his way. A dominant pass receiver that can break down any defense, because when he's doing that kind of work, it really hurts you on the back end.
And even though it's an incompletion there, I think they're going back to that well. Play action. Now it's Mahomes. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete. Fourth down now as San Fran's defense was strong in coverage.
Back-to-back incompletions of what was once a nice drive stalled out here. I'm going to give credit to the secondary, partner. Never gave up as they gave up a few yards, and they came through on that play to deny that pass and force the fourth down.
Butker's kick here is good, and they're back within a touchdown at 17-10. So the 3 points there in CD, that helps them inch a bit closer.
Yeah, partner, when you're losing, any points you see go on the board in your favor, you're happy to take them.
After the field goal, here's Butker to kick it away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. Christian McCaffrey and his 49er teammates back onto the field. He's already cruised past the 100-yard mark. We haven't even gone away for halftime yet.
He might not want halftime. All right, why cool off?
Keep everybody here.
Let's stay out on the field and keep going. But all that being said, everything is really working well for them. The play calling's been excellent. The blocking's been terrific. And obviously his vision and legs have hurdled him to this big number so far. We could be seeing something really special here.
And we'll see how much they give him the ball here. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27.
Now that's a run that warms a play caller's heart, because you're actually set up to do whatever you want on offense. You can come right back and run essentially the same play because you have momentum. Or you can fake that running play and throw something deep over the top. Or you now feel like you have an extra down to play with, because if you go ahead and just throw it and you don't get it, come back and try and pick it up on third down.
Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. Call it a gain of 3 on the play. And they'll be faced with a 3rd and inches. Two minutes on the clock in the second quarter of this Super Bowl. A reminder, coming up at intermission, we'll get highlights of this Super Bowl from Jonathan Coachman and the crew in Orlando for our EA Sports Halftime Report. And he is going to have a Niners first down, and comfortably so, as he gets 5 there on 3rd and 1 yard.
That's a big conversion there on 3rd down, because they did not want to give the ball up here late in the half. They'd love to take the clock all the way down and score. This will definitely help the cause.
So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. Purdy now to throw. The tight end Kittle has it on the left side.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
From the 38 now, here comes 2nd and 8. Purdy looking to throw. A throw on the run, but that's going to be incomplete.
You can tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
So the failure to connect on 2nd down, that leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8. Purdy will look to throw again here. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he'll be brought down with a 1st down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs' 44-yard line. Right about 20 yards on the pickup. And officially, they'll say it's going to go for 19.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon, and it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a 1st down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
On 1st down, Purdy. That one complete to his receiver, Jennings. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on 1st down. Now a timeout called for by the offense as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the 1st half.
I got you, baby.
Second down and a yard.
Once more, Purdy looking to throw. That's over the middle and caught by Ayuk. And they are into field goal range now as he's got the first down at the 26.
Purdy to throw it on first down.
They're unable to connect, but a late flag comes in. And the contact may have come too early.
So the contact came before the ball got there, and the flag is thrown.
Timing is everything, isn't it? And it's so hard to cover these great receivers. They have such great body control, and they can fake you out. In this case, as you described, got there before the ball got to the receiver. Penalty flag had to come out.
Touchdown! George Kittle, as the first half is winding down. And the Niners continue to look good here in the first half of this Super Bowl.
Partner, to me, that touchdown had something that was kind of rooted in that group seeing the future. What I mean by that is they had a plan. Let's find a way to score right here before the half, and that'll give us momentum going into the second half, give us that cushion that we're looking for. They got that accomplished, scoring right before the half ended.
Moody good with the extra point.
And the lead now up to 14. A good drive that time as they go 9 plays in all.
And it all ends with a George Kittle touchdown. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And he'll be brought down right on the chalk of the 20.
The KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball, just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Mahomes going to throw. Throwing the out route here, and it's complete to Kelce. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end, a guy that you can line up anywhere, in the slot, out wide, in tight, doesn't really matter. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch.
Now Mahomes,
complete, the tight end Kelce. And he'll be out of bounds up near the 45 at the 44.
So we've reached halftime here in the Super Bowl. As we send you to our EA studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Back to you guys in a bit. But first, we welcome everyone to our EA Sports Halftime Report. The highlights are fairly one-sided to this point. It's a 2-touchdown difference here at the break. But I wouldn't call this one over just yet. I think there could still be some fireworks yet to come.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3.
I know you hate.
These two teams sat through a longer than usual 30-minute wait, but we're back in action here in this Super Bowl. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. Here comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to begin quarter number three. And they're on the short end of the scoreboard here. Charles, what adjustments, if any, do you think they need to make for the second half?
We're paraphrasing the gold medal hockey winning coach Herb Brooks. I just say you continue to play your game. Throw the ball. They had success doing it in the first half. So make sure you keep getting the ball to your playmakers, a little bit more to the perimeter perhaps. But above all, play your game.
Meanwhile, Mahomes throw complete there to Rice. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down. Headed straight, it's Pacheco. And a loose football. And now this is scooped up by the 49ers. And his guys are going to get the football at their own 47-yard line. So it's kind of more of the same offensively. This was a team needing to come out of this third quarter with a little fire. Instead, they put the ball on the ground.
And you know that has to be the discussion at halftime because they're down two scores. We got to come out with a little bit more urgency than we had in the first half. Now that urgency falls on their defense because they can't fall down three scores and hope to come back and win this game.
Here's a look at the 49ers offense as they make their way out for their first possession of the second half. And their defense just helped them out by getting the football back on the opening drive here of the second half. And now can the offense follow through with points on their first possession?
And that's a big one for them because after the work the defense has done, they've got a chance here to open up this lead.
They start on the ground with McCaffrey. And he'll take it across the 50 and into Chief territory.
124 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
What a way to start a drive. An excellent run, a tone setter, and now if you want to take a shot on second down and go play action, make it look like the same exact play and throw it over the top, you can do so because you've established the run in a big way.
And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Here's Samuel.
And this winds up a pickup of two, maybe two and a half, to about the 39.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
Ball on the 39. Here's second down and eight.
Up the gut, McCaffrey. And he gets this to the 35. Good for a gain of five.
But really, that was no surprise there. They've been running it well all game. And I know goals change all the time, but any team will take that type of run each and every time.
Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first.
Third down, here's McCaffrey. And he won't get to the marker. He's a yard short. A pickup of three, it leaves him with fourth and one.
This team doesn't mind running the ball in any situation, and I thought he was going to get the first down the way the play developed, but the defense closed in and stopped him just about a yard short.
Boy, a call like this, certainly tougher to make in a Super Bowl, but they'll go for it on fourth down.
Purdy bootlegging it.
And it's going to be batted down. It will go the other way with the football. The Niners go for it, but it doesn't work out. And the Chiefs defense comes up with a stop.
Fourth down, and they take to the air, which really isn't a major surprise, but how about the coverage? They're able to bat it down.
And the Chiefs now getting set to go.
Right now, they're in a bit of a tough spot here, CD. You trail them by double digits. Remember the last time out,
They fumbled. They're going to have to play some clean football here on this possession.
And all the talk on their sideline has been about taking care of the football, making sure that they're handling the ball correctly. So you know they'll be squeezing the rock pretty tight here. They just have to be careful not to go so hard in doing that that they actually cause themselves other problems. Take care of the ball, but still try and play free and natural.
It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
That's a nice run to get himself back on the horse after his fumble. Nothing spectacular, but a good confidence-building run.
This 2nd and 4. Mahomes now to throw. Got an open man. It's Valdez Scantling. Down the left sideline. And finally taken down at the 15. A big play there for KC. 47 yards.
This is what made the West Coast offense a staple around the NFL in the 80s and 90s. You don't have to push the ball deep downfield to come up with big plays. And there's an example of that right there.
So after the big play, look at this. All the way down at the 15 now on 1st and 10. Here's Mahomes to throw. And it's caught. And all the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds. Another nice gain. 13 yards that time and another first down.
How about the way they're moving the ball down the field? They had a big play a moment ago. Followed it up with another nice one here. And before you know it, they're already looking at 1st and goal.
Pacheco diving for the end zone, and he'll get there. Touchdown. Just power football there down near the goal line. Give it to him. He's able to push his way across.
Yeah, they went heavy there. Sometimes you have those big offensive linemen come and have to report like they're eligible. But all they're doing is getting a good stance, blocking, and getting their runner across the goal line.
Extra point by Butker is on target, and that cuts the lead to 24-17. After the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. San Francisco set to go on offense once more. And their lead cut in half by that touchdown a moment ago. They are up 7 as they begin this drive, 1st and 10. Throwing here, Purdy. And the Chiefs are going to get him. That was Nick Bolton rushing in and burying him behind the line.
Well, certainly going to be a lot tougher adding a touchdown to that lead now since they're facing 2nd and 20+. Big-time sack to start the drive and put the opponent way back. Let's see what kind of play call they come up with here.
Well, they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's 2nd and 21. McCaffrey running up the middle. And he takes this across the 15 to the 17. Give him 4 yards there, but still in a big hole. 3rd and long.
I don't care what the emphasis is in the NFL at any given time. Every defense is still going to say their number one goal every game is stop the run. And right now, they're not doing that. And that really chips away at your confidence.
Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. He'll get this underneath to McCaffrey. And they're able to bring him down at the 20. He did his best to just get four out of that, but not enough. And now fourth down.
How about that strategy there, Brandon? Third down, they just said, we've got faith in our tacklers. We'll give you the short stuff, and just decided to protect the sticks. So every time I hear fans telling me tackling's not a part of the game anymore, plays like that, I can clip and save and show them you have to tackle well if you want to be a good defense.
Call that a punt of 38 yards officially, and it's Chiefs football, first and 10. And now here comes Kansas City.
This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game planned for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
Here's Pacheco to begin the drive. And he'll be brought down at the 50 after a gain of about five.
I think we all suspected that they were going back to him after he found the end zone on his last carry. And they kept the positive momentum going there. Another nice run by him.
Ball right on the 50-yard line. Here's second down and five. Here's Pacheco once again. And he stopped immediately there. They'll say no gain on the play there. Now it'll be third down. He's already fumbled once in this game, and I thought the ball started to jostle there a little bit, but they got to him quickly at the line of scrimmage.
They sure did. And remember, if you're not a very confident runner and you've already dropped it once, if there's traffic around you, the only thing you think about is protecting the football, not gaining yards.
From midfield, here's Mahomes. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Well, a lot of times when you get a manageable third down situation like this, you have to think about your tight end, and he comes through for him, picking up the first down.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. To throw, it's Mahomes. That one caught by Rice. And he's going to get a solid gain of nine before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Ah, that's tough to play zone defense when they can just curl up right there in front of you.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, we talk about finding the soft spot defensively. How do you make sure they don't find the soft spot like they did there?
Tough to do, because what they normally will do is run routes that'll pull you out of that spot they want to get into. That's what we call not taking the cheese, right? Don't go for the mousetrap. But it's hard to do, because when you see a guy cutting that in that direction, you tend to go towards him.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. And again, it's Mahomes. Another catch for Valdez Scantling. They'll wind up getting seven on the play, and that's going to bring up second down.
And we've seen him have success earlier on with the ball in his hands, because he is a get-it-in-space-and-make-a-play kind of a receiver. But that time, they closed on him quickly and held him to a short game.
Here's second and three. Throwing now is Mahomes. And he'll go down. Brought down at the 20-yard line. Nick Bosa, his second sack of the night.
And keep in mind, in addition to the two sacks that he now has, CD, he's also had a couple of quarterback hurries. He's been very disruptive.
To put it mildly, and it reminds me of the time I asked an offensive tackle who struggled like this in a game. He said he was telling the coach, hey, what do you want me to do? This guy's just eating me alive. And the coach finally just looked at him and said, applaud.
After the sack, things get a little tougher here. Third and long for Mahomes and the Chiefs. And he is caught. And the Chiefs are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
A very important third down conversion right there, because when you're trailing and find yourself this deep in enemy territory, the kicker's not even part of your thought process. You got to make it pay off with six. Nice connection right there to set up first and goal.
Now here's Mahomes. And in for the Chiefs.
touchdown. Rashee Rice, a 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Chiefs are an extra point away from tying up this Super Bowl.
A really well-executed fade route offers little risk for the offense. If you throw it to the outside where only the receiver can get it, it's either a touchdown or an incompletion, but no big play for the defense.
Butker on for the PAT. And that will tie our game here in the third quarter. So that drive consumes 9 plays all told. And it winds up with the Chiefs hitting pay dirt. Nothing separating these two sides. 24 all our score as he sends this one away. Taken at the goal line. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. The 49ers offense now, they get set to head back on the field. And their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. Here's Purdy. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
Well, he certainly thought he had a window to push that ball downfield, but as soon as he released the throw, the corner was there to slam that window shut.
Third quarter of the biggest spectacle in sport, the Super Bowl. Thanks for joining us, everybody. Second and 10. This is Samuel. Move will yield nothing as he stopped behind the line. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time because, let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
Tough spot here. Third down and 11. Shotgun now with Purdy. He's got his target. That's complete. And he is going to have a 49ers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them. And these guys have been taking advantage so far.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Shotgun handoff now to McCaffrey. And he'll grab a gain of 5 out of this up to the 41-yard line.
That's a really good gain right there. They pick up 5 yards halfway to a first down. The only problem now in the huddle, everyone's going to want to touch the football. Be a lot of chattering now because they've seen that they can move the line of scrimmage.
From the 41, here's a second and 5. Purdy looking to throw. He'll get this into the hands of Ayuk. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Well, they obviously red man covers their partner, and he got downfield, broke down the defender, made him
think. What do you mean by that?
Yeah, he made him think he was going to run a different route. Probably thought he was going to take it upfield, and then he curls back inside for the completion.
Now on first down, it's Purdy.
And his throw is going to be incomplete.
This could be the start of a nice stand from this defense now after getting walked backwards on this drive. Come through with another one here, and you have them staring at a third and long, and that puts the defense in a position to dictate to the offense.
Third quarter, Super Bowl 58. Here's a second and 10 now. Back to throw, Purdy. Connects with Kittle underneath. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and 1.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end,
Now it gives them a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
We are through three quarters of play here from Allegiant Stadium. It's Super Bowl 58.
We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. So they'll try to move the ball closer here on third down. A field goal from this spot would be just inside of 60 yards, 59 to be exact. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. It's a gain of 8, and it'll wind up moving the chains.
And the tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then, of course, they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play, and that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
Play action. Now Purdy.
This will be caught. It's Samuel. And they'll get this one to about the 20-yard line.
The Niners passing game in sync now. They've got another first down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Purdy sets up to throw again. He'll get this to Jennings over the middle.
That'll go for a gain of 7. And that will bring up second down. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to it? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
A second down throw for Purdy.
And there's that man again. It's complete.
And the 49ers are going to have a first and goal as the tackle is made at about the 5.
Well, he does have one touchdown in the game already, and while this one won't go for 6, it's enough to get him first and goal, but you and I both know he's going to be a little upset he didn't cross the goal line for a second time in this one.
Might want the ball here on the next play.
They go play action here, Purdy. It's caught by Deebo Samuel. Touchdown, San Francisco.
A 5-yard touchdown catch.
And the 49ers answer back with a touchdown of their own to break our tie and take the lead here in the 4th.
So, Charles, this game feels like it has been punch, counterpunch all throughout, and that touchdown breaks our tie here in the 4th quarter.
You're making me want to get back in the gym and start training again. You talk about those punches and counterpunches. I also think this is where you and I start thinking to ourselves, who's going to make the play to change that, right? Who's going to get out of this little cycle that they're in right now and make a play and give their team a firm advantage?
Moody good with the extra point.
And they will take a 7-point lead.
So following the touchdown, here's Moody back out to send it away. This taken in at the goal line. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. Another drive coming for KC, and we'll see Marquez Valdes-Scantling once again.
He's been a load for them to handle defensively, I know that much.
Look at him. He's got 7 catches on the game, and he's starting to shred them a little bit because not only is he catching them, he's picking up good yardage, keeping the chains moving, ball control, you name it. This big guy, what did you say? He's been a load for them to handle?
That's right.
He's agreed.
This has 7 catches, as you said, over 100 yards. On 1st and 10, here's Mahomes. Over the middle, and it's incomplete.
Everything about that play tells you about today's NFL offenses and what they're asking out of running backs. You can't just be a guy who can run the football. You have to be able to catch it as well, and he didn't get that done on that play.
After the incompletion, here's 2nd and 10 from the 20.
Pacheco gets it up the gut. And only a couple there up to about the 23-yard line.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
The offense on third down tonight, they've had good success. 5 for 8 to this point. This is 3rd and 8. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Rice. And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. Call it a gain of 6 on the play, and it'll be 4th down. He got out of bounds. That's a good thing, but still short of the first.
And now, since this brings up 4th down, the defensive play caller, grab your nerves, because now you don't want to be so amped up that you give them a 1st down by getting out of your lanes, but you also don't want to just lay back and let them have it easily.
So a change of possession here on the punt, and it will be 1st and 10 as they take over. The 49ers ready to set up shop again offensively. They have the lead, obviously, late in the game. I guess the good news for them is if for some reason they would make a mistake, a field goal does the opposition no good.
Everyone loves to have a little bit of a cushion, and that helps you immeasurably. But the bottom line is, do all the things that you're taught in order to close out the game. Don't even let that become an issue.
Yeah, but still a one possession game. This one not fully over yet. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. Good yardage as he rumbles for 24 out of first.
That outside handoff to the left, that play has to warm the heart of an offensive line coach, because they controlled the left side where they were supposed to. They didn't allow anything to leak from the backside on the right side of the offensive line either. Well played.
Yeah, and it created a big run. On 1st down, Purdy throwing quickly there, but it's incomplete. Not sure what happened out there, but looked like the timing was a little off on that throw.
Well, you know I'm a defender, so what am I going to say?
Great defense.
And darn right, they did something to disrupt that timing.
An incomplete pass on 1st down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. Purdy now to throw. Over the middle, that's complete to McCaffrey. And he'll be brought down with a 1st down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs 35. They give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
And these guys certainly are not hiding what their intention is. They're absolutely showing it. They're definitely not going to sit on this lead here in the 4th quarter.
Purdy bootlegging it. Rush coming and he's taken down. Willie Gay getting in there and picking up the sack. Remember, they had the nice gain on the previous play, but they just gave a lot of it back right there on that sack.
Yeah, they get the sack, get back some real estate. Felt like the type of play that can spark a defense and swing some momentum. Almost felt like a take that type of a play, didn't it, partner?
Gotta imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on 2nd down following the sack. It's 2nd and 18. Purdy. A quick throw there is incomplete.
I can assure you, setting up a screen is much more difficult than it appears. It requires excellent timing from everyone on the offense, and a defense's number one goal is to throw that timing off.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. Now Purdy.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
Here comes the 49ers punter now, as he's on here to punt it away. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. Now the Chiefs offense, they get ready to head on the field. And it's quickly becoming now or never time in the Super Bowl, trailing by 7 here in the 4th. A pivotal, pivotal moment in this football game. Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up 1st and 10 at the 20. They'll try and start this drive in the air. That ball is caught. Marquez Valdes-Scantling. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. 25 yards that time.
I like the design that we're seeing right there. This is what they need. Down by a touchdown here in the fourth. They just need to keep working their way downfield. And when they see openings, take their shots.
The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already. Now Mahomes. Got an open man. It's Valdes-Scantling. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Consecutive catches for him. That good for 11. And that last reception puts him over 150 yards now on the game, Charles.
And now it's not just execution. It's not just performance. It's a mental aspect that's going on. Because right now, he's got the defense so much on their heels. Got them looking at each other. Who's going to cover this guy? And what type of coverage can we put out there to try and slow him down?
A gain of 3, second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Looking to throw is Mahomes. And down he goes. The 49ers get there. Nick Bosa bringing the pressure yet again. That's his third sack here tonight.
And that's his third sack, and that ties a Super Bowl record. Makes me think of my old college teammate, Reggie White. He had 3 with the Green Bay Packers in Super Bowl 31. Darnell Dockett of Arizona, Super Bowl 43. And Coney Ealy, 3 sacks for the Panthers against Denver in Super Bowl 50.
All those sacks, they've only been an official record since Super Bowl 17. I know it's believed that L.C. Greenwood unofficially had 4 way back in Super Bowl 10.
Wearing the golden high tops as well.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Looking for Tony on the out route, and he's got him. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. It'll be a pickup of 14, but they're still a little bit short as it brings up fourth.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping them from the first down.
That stopped him in his tracks. And he is going to have the Chiefs first down as the defense couldn't come up with a big play. In fact, they got 6 more than they needed, a gain of 8 on 4th and 2. On the handoff, it's Pacheco. And only a yard this time as he's taken down right around the 26.
That felt like a trap because it looked to me like the opposing front was on that play from the get-go. They had everyone crashing the ball carrier before he even made the line, and they hold him to just a yard.
So from the 26-yard line, here's 2nd and 9. Here's Mahomes to throw. Nowhere to turn here, and he's going to go down. Back at about the 37-yard line. Nick Bosa make that now 4 sacks for him in tonight's ball game.
And that's a Super Bowl record, his 4th sack of the game. I think we got to start thinking seriously about making him the Super Bowl MVP as well.
I think you're right. With him leading in the driver's seat, he certainly has a shot. Gonna need better protection here. 3rd and long following the sack for Mahomes and company. He'll drop to throw. And this will be caught by his big wide receiver. 14 yards is the pickup there, but it'll still lead to a 4th down.
Charles, he's now over 400 yards passing in this one. It feels like he has a zillion completions. Just a very memorable effort from a guy that we thought could be in line for a big game, and he has exceeded our expectation.
That he has, and I'm not really surprised at all, because when you look at this offensive unit, they are loaded across the board. And of course, the guy throwing him, he's a big-time player himself. They brought it from start to finish and really helped get the better of the opposing secondary.
Felt compelled to go for it there on fourth down, trailing in the fourth quarter. They got it done.
And there's always a lot of pressure on a fourth down call. Doesn't matter the distance. You stop to get it done, as you noted, and they did.
They'll run here with Pacheco. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. 5 yards, a good run there, and now second and goal.
It's largely been the air attack that's gotten them down here, but now is where you start to lean on that running game. That's a good pickup there on first and goal.
From the 2 now, second and goal. Now they'll bring one of their tight ends in motion right. Pacheco once more. And he's going to take it into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Isaiah Pacheco, his second touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Chiefs are an extra point away from tying this game here in the fourth. And we are set up for a fantastic finish now. A fourth quarter touchdown here. We're an extra point away from a tie football game.
And I know they're thinking about possibly going for two, but I'd go ahead and kick this one and just get it back to level.
Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And partner, we've got a tie game here in the fourth. This Super Bowl, it has had it all so far. All tied fourth quarter as it kicks away. This fielded right at the goal line. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The 49ers offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And this Super Bowl has been as good as advertised. Probably one of the best that we've seen in recent memory. All even here in this fourth quarter. Purdy going to lead the 49ers to the line, first and 10 at their own 24. The drive begins with a run by McCaffrey, and he'll work this forward for about 3. It's second down.
Not a lot of running room there, not a place to make a cut and kind of exit out because they had everything bottled up. Looked to me like the linemen were taking on their blocks really well and giving up no creases.
Here's a second and 7. Play action, and now here's Purdy to throw it. McCaffrey's got it. He caught it right at the line of scrimmage, and before he could even think about advancing it forward, he got hit.
Great tackling, because that's what you're taught. Don't give up yards after the catch, and most offenses make a living off of yards after catch. As hidden yards, it may not go into the score sheet, but they count big for moving the ball and stretching the field. Really nice open field tackle.
Now throw on third down there, but he cannot connect. Defensively, mission accomplished, and now with under 3 to go, they may be the last team holding the football.
They may very well be the last team holding the football, unless, of course, you're facing a group that is really aggressive offensively and may want to take a gamble. But theoretically, you've done your job now. You should get the ball back on a punt, but I'd be alert for a fake.
Fair catch called for and made right at the 25-yard line. So possession goes over here on the punt. Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. Excellent job by their defense to force the punt and provide them with this opportunity, all tied in the fourth quarter. Here's first and 10. Mahomes now to throw. That's complete to Tony. And they will get him down, but not before he gets very good yardage there, as that will lead us right into the 2-minute warning. So the Chiefs in possession of the ball as we welcome you back. They've got it first and 10 as they search for a go-ahead score. On first down, Mahomes.
Throw right side, taken in by the tight end Gray.
And this will be good for a pickup of 9 to the 46.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
They'll come up now on second down. Mahomes. And that one caught by Rice. And he is taken down, and he's got a first. And they are on the precipice of field goal range now.
Now you're right on the edge of field goal range. You've still got time, but get up to the line of scrimmage and get set.
Plenty of time. All three timeouts still remain. Here's first and 10 now. They run it with Pacheco from the gun.
And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up. They're making steady progress, but I see your face. You're worried about that clock.
I'm worried about the clock, and at some point, you have to have a splash play in there as well.
Second down, 8 yards to go. Again, it's Pacheco.
Fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. And the 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 seconds to go in the game.
What a Super Bowl it's been to this point. Now a critical third down here. A handoff now for Pacheco.
And it's not going to be enough here. A gain of 4, about 2 feet short of the marker. Fourth down. So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. This to take the lead here in the final minute. Butker's kick here is good. And the sideline celebrates as they have taken the lead in the final minute. All right, so time to reset here. It's a huge kick there, gives them the lead, but they've got to be careful that their celebrations aren't a little too premature.
You're exactly right about that, because there still is time for the other guys to run a few plays and get into field goal position. So this defense is going to need to come up with one final stop if they're going to get out of here with a victory.
After the field goal, here's Butker to kick it away. And with time a factor here late, he'll just take a knee and they'll put it out to the 25.
So Purdy and the Niners down 34-31, a little over 30 seconds remaining.
They need at least a field goal to send this Super Bowl to overtime as they come up on first down.
Here's Purdy to throw.
His throw incomplete.
Another try, second and 10 now. To throw is Purdy. Finding Samuel. And he'll be brought down after a gain of about 9, and compounding things, it's now third down as well.
And the clock will now stop as a timeout is called with 5 seconds left.
This definitely four down territory at this point, but a critical third down here. Purdy with one final shot here.
Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And it's incomplete. So their final drive comes up empty. And with that, the ball game is over. And the Kansas City Chiefs are the Super Bowl champions.
For the victors, getting to hoist that Lombardi trophy, you know, we've talked to guys that have done it, and they say there's no better feeling in sports.
I don't know how there can be. The journey to get to this game is incredible. And then to finally break through and win it when all eyes are on this game alone because there's nothing else going on, that's just got to be absolutely amazing. That the task, incredible. But the accomplishment, forever.